Benvenuto! Welcome to Cherry Hill Home Cooking. My name is Mark. Before I say anything else, if you hear some banging in the background, we're having some work done on our garage, so that's that. What that is. Wade isn't throwing things at me from behind the camera. So anyway, depending upon when you watch this, it's only a couple weeks to Thanksgiving. So I thought I would show you guys how I make my stuffing or dressing, and we'll get more into that in a minute. But this is a simple, as far as I'm concerned, a simple, delicious cornbread stuffing. I've been making this for many years. It's not a typical, like Southern style cornbread stuffing, which has got everything but the kitchen sink, including eggs in it. This is more of a New England style, I guess. All right, so we're going to do cornbread stuffing. I always do cornbread stuffing. That's what Wade and I have liked in over the years. Anyone that's been to our house for Thanksgiving has liked it as well. So, all right, I use the Petrich's Farms Cornbread Classic Stuffing. All right, now, this is already pre-seasoned. I have tried making this with my own homemade cornbread, and quite frankly, I just didn't think it came out as well. So I've always stuck to this. Certainly if you want to make a cornbread, of average size cornbread, and break it up and toast it, go for it. But anyway, I use the prepared Petrich's Farms Cornbread Classic Stuffing. Okay, so for this, I'm going to make one bag full of this. Now, normally Thanksgiving, I make two, and I stuff the turkey, and then I also cook some along the side. And again, we'll talk about that in a minute. But the other thing we're going to need is one stick of melted butter. You can use salted or unsalted, whatever you have. It's not that big of a deal. All right, now, I don't have any of my homemade turkey stock this year, which I'm going to make some, maybe sometime next week. But anyway, I was able to find them. Every once in a while, you can find turkey broth around this time of the year in the supermarket. So I picked that up. We're gonna need 2 cups of that. And again, Wade will put that all in the directions and the description and so on and so forth. Like I said, it is already pre-seasoned. I like to add a little bit more, so I'm gonna use a little bit more of ground sage and ground thyme. All right, and we need salt and pepper, of course. And we need a cup of celery. I did most of it, but anyway, usually what I'll, so that's probably 4 or 5, maybe 6 stalks of celery, depending on how big your celery stalks are. Now, I do like to cut them a little on the thin side. They'll cook faster, and but that's all there is to it. I just thought I'd show you how I cut them up. Excuse me, I just burped. This microphone is so close to me, it picks up every sound. Okay, then the next thing we need is a cup of white onion. This is a white sweet onion, whatever type of onion you got. We've chopped up onions lots and lots of time. I've cut it in half. I left the root end on. And then I'm just going to kind of, for my purpose, to get some little dice, slice it like that. And if you don't go all the way through to the root end, then it will stay together. And I've got almost a cup here, so I'm not going to need all of this. And then I just cut it up like that. All right. Could it be easier? All right. Now, of course, we're not going to waste this. We'll use that for something else. Now, I also use one whole Granny Smith apple. Peeled, of course. Okay. And again, I like to, now, again, this is stuffing. You can add anything you want to this. I have done it a couple years with dried cranberries. You can even add beef or pork to this if you want. Of course, if you do want to keep this vegetarian, substitute the turkey broth for vegetable broth. And, as long as you're vegetarian, if you eat dairy, it should be good. All right, so anyway, our apple. So I just cut it, core it, slice it into 4s. And again, I want to cut them relatively thin. We're going to saute these for a few moments. So these are going to really cook up nice. And The reason I like to cut them small is, and that's just one large Granny Smith apple. The reason I cut them up small like that is, like I said, we're gonna saute them a little bit, but also then when you either put it in your stuffing or you cook it alongside your bird, the apple almost just dissolves and it just gives you that little bit of sweet tangy. All right, I said we'll talk about stuffing dressing. Okay, so the difference between stuffing and dressing, of course, is if you stuff the turkey or whatever type of fowl you're going to be stuffing with your stuffing, then it's called stuffing. If you cook it alongside, then it's called dressing. So technically, we're making dressing today because we're going to cook this alongside in a casserole. Like I said, I usually do two packages of this. And I usually get about an 18-pound turkey, and I stuff the both cavities of the turkey with the stuffing with one pack, and then I cook another 2-quart on the side, because of course the stuffing that the stuffing that I stuff the turkey with goes really, really fast, and then I find we don't have any stuffing for leftovers over the next few days. So anyway, before we cut, we're just going to get this or cut and go clean this up a bit. Oh, and we're gonna need a 2-quart lightly buttered pan. If you don't have one with a cover, cover it with tinfoil, of course. So I'm gonna just start sauteing our celery and onion. So we've got maybe a tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil, and we got some butter in there. Butter. And we'll let that melt. So I did have it hotter, but I turned it down because it was really hot standing here waiting for Wade to start recording. Oop, it's gotten quiet out there.
I say you always blame anything on me.
Of course. You've gone after all these years, you're not used to it. It's always your fault. All right, so I'm going to put my, what are these? Celery in first. And I'm going to turn this up again a little bit more. I have made this and put sausage in it. You know, you fry up your sausage. And I have done it, you know, a couple times here and there. But for Thanksgiving, I always kind of like it to be the same. So I, from the most part, have always made it like this. Because I had that screeching hot before. Now it does want to come back up. All right, a couple other things I wanted to mention. Now, if you were going to do this as stuffing, I wouldn't make it the night before. You could, you can saute your veggies up and, you know, put those in a bowl, cover it, and put it in the refrigerator overnight. And then when you're going to get ready to stuff the turkey, I just throw them in the microwave for a minute or so, bring it back to room temperature. Because you don't want to make the entire stuffing ahead of time and then put that in the refrigerator overnight, because then when you go to stuff your turkey in the morning, you're going to be putting cold turkey, cold stuffing into your turkey, and it's not going to cook properly. So if you're going to stuff the turkey, again, do this procedure without putting in your broth and your stuffing and stuff, mixing it all together. But like I said, you can saute the veggies, put those in the refrigerator, heat them up in the morning, then proceed with the rest of the recipe, and then stuff your turkey. If you're going to do it as dressing, you certainly could do everything overnight, put it in your pan, and just leave that in the refrigerator. All right, so we finally started to come up a little bit. My goal here is to kind of start to get the veggies tender. They don't have to be mushy, but I do want to get them tender. I think I did say a little salt and pepper. Of course, salt and pepper is going to be to taste. I'm going to salt our veggies as we cook through. All right, so we're going to put our onions in. And that's going to take a good 10 minutes or so for everything to start to get where I want it. All right, so with that, like I said, I'm going to save my apples. I'm not going to put those in right now because those will start to cook really fast. So anyway, Let me put a little bit of salt for our onions. And I would say, I mean, that's a pinch of salt. So probably in total, I don't use more than, I do have a half of teaspoon of salt and pepper in here. So for the whole thing, it's no more than a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of pepper. All right, we'll come back when our veggies have softened up and we'll go on. In the meantime, we'll clean up our mess here. All right, I've preheated my oven to 350 degrees, okay, as I've been sauteing my onions and celery. I've added a little bit more, a little bit more drop of olive oil and another little pat of butter. I would say probably about 2 tablespoons of each, so 2 tablespoons olive oil and 2 tablespoons butter. Remember, this is Thanksgiving. It's not low in calories. I have also, done a couple pinches of salt. I'll give it my last pinch of salt here. And we'll do some pepper. And again, like I said, that's probably going to be a total of a teaspoon of each. And I'm going to throw my apples in there. Let those start to cook up a little bit as we finish. So give those a little stir in there. I don't know, someone's sending me all kinds of stuff. It's all our subscribers saying how wonderful we are. So we'll just, I'm really just kind of breaking those little apple pieces up, getting them distributed. One got away. All right, so here we've got our package of breadcrumbs. I'm gonna take my seasoning. I put that in a little thing here, and I'm gonna give that a stir. Make sure that's all mixed in. Now it smells like Thanksgiving. So tonight we're not gonna have a full Thanksgiving meal, but I am gonna make chicken, and we'll have some canned sweet potatoes with it, and so on. But, and I'm just gonna let those go a couple more minutes. And while we're waiting for this, do you have any questions, Wade?
No, I don't.
Oh, good. Of course, I didn't need a really big pan, so I thought, okay, I'm going to use this little hot plate, whatever they call it. What do they call those? That's just the electric one. And I, instead of dragging out one of the induction ones, or I would have to use a bigger pan. And this does not keep the heat as well as the other one. How's it smell? Good?
It does.
So, we've got our oven heated at 350. Now, if I was, of course, if you're going to use this as stuffing, you're going to follow the rest of what we're doing here, and then you're going to stuff your bread with it. And of course, importantly, you're going to make it according to the package directions. And of course, that's going to cook. Usually you roast turkey at, I think, 325, usually. So I'll just put the, I usually will do the extra stuffing in a loaf pan, cover tightly with tinfoil, and put it alongside the bird. And I'll just let it cook the whole time that the bird does. I would say for the dressing, we're going to be at 350, and I'm going to say 40, 45 minutes or so, because really everything here is cooked. We just want everything to get heated through. Now, I don't necessarily like a really crusty top to it. If you do, just put it in the oven uncovered. I'm gonna put it in my pan and cover it. And really, the only thing I'm wasting time here is I wanted those apples to cook a little bit. And I think that will be pretty good. You can see our onions are translucent. Our celery has just started to soften up, because it's gonna continue to bake, or to cook in the oven. Okay, let me shut that off. And then I always take my veggies. Those in and give it a stir. Get everything mixed together. That should fit in that 2-quart pan. Hopefully. Yeah, once we add our butter and our broth to it, it's gonna start to stick together a bit. All right, then we got our stick of melted butter. Get that tossing around. I know, probably, and maybe it's just because we don't have it all that often, but stuffing is always my two favorite parts of Thanksgiving dinner are the stuffing and sweet potatoes. And again, we have stuffing a few times a year, especially if I make the crock pot pork chops, but we don't really have stuffing all that often. And then even with that, I just use the stovetop one. All right, and we got our 2 cups of broth. Put that halfway in and start to toss it about. So this is going to give you a stuffing that's going to be moist and it's going to stick together. It's not going to fall apart on you. Like I said, sometimes in southern style cornbread recipes, you see eggs or cream or some other type of liquid going in to keep it together, but this is not a southern style. Pretty good. I'm going to give this a quick taste just for seasoning, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be good. Perfect. It's a little salty. It's savory. Delicious. And of course, if you wanted to add a little bit more salt and pepper, you could, but I think it's good. So at this point, I would probably, if I was stuffing the turkey right now, I would have made this, put a thin cover of plastic wrap over it, and then I would wash the turkey and stuff. So it would have sat for 10 minutes or so. Not 100% necessary, but that's how I would have done it. So I don't know if you can see that it is moist, and of course as everything heats up and it cooks, the cornbread is gonna even absorb more of our broth. sorry about the bottom of our bowl here, or the back of the bottom. Okay, now, I would cover it. I'd let it bake for at least, 35 minutes or so, covered. And then if you want the top to get a little bit crispy, browned, uncover it, put it back in for 10 minutes or so. All right, so we're gonna cover it. We've got our oven all ready. And we're gonna get it baking. Okay, set a timer for 45 minutes.
Okay, 45 minutes.
And we'll see you
now
in 45 minutes. Okay, it's 45 minutes later. Let's see what we got. Oop, burn my microphone. Ooh, that looks good. Actually, I'm gonna bring it right over there, but Wade asked me, so you're gonna bring it right over the counter? So I don't know if you can see, but our sides have browned a little bit. It's bubbling up, there's little bubbles. That's what you want. It should be heated through. Like I said, I let mine go 45 minutes. If you wanted to, at this point, if you wanted to brown the top a little bit more, like I said, I'd take the top off and put it in, or maybe about 15 minutes before it's done. But I know stuffing is one of those things. The longer it stays warm, the more delicious it gets. So, all right, well, I am looking forward to having that tonight with our dinner. And I'm not going to take the cover off. Wade will show you that in the pictures. Well, we're back for the best part, eating. And I am starving. Seems like we've been going all day long. It looks really, really dark out, but it's really not that late. But we got our nice little semi-Thanksgiving dinner. We've got some sauteed green beans and some sweet potatoes and some roast chicken. And what's this red stuff in there?
Cranberry sauce.
Have to have cranberry sauce with this stuffing. But the star of the plate today is my stuffing. Let's give it a taste. It looks good.
Delicious.
I love this stuffing. Okay, that's... Actually, I have one more thing to say. Of course, a couple things. Hope you guys all enjoyed watching us make our cornbread stuffing and accompanying with our dinner. I hope you make it. If you do, don't forget, let us know.
Oh, yeah. I've been to a lot of Thanksgiving dinners, and everyone makes their stuffing differently. Some make it with special K's.
We actually, a couple of years, spent time with close friends, their parents, and not with special cornflakes.
Cornflakes, yeah.
Yeah, both made it with cornflakes.
You want a good stuffing, dressing, this is it.
Of course,
because
I'm eating, right?
Yeah, I'm not saying
it's
true.
Awesome.
Thank you. Please like and subscribe and check out CherryHillHomeCooking.com. And we'll see you in the next video.
Ciao.
Bye.
That is so good.